What's good, everybody? I hope you're having yourselves a lovely day. Welcome back to another banger. I got another video for y'all today. It's gonna be another story time. Come through to the streams, bro. I'm trying to stream more often. I'm gonna have a link in the description. I'm updating my description. It's been so long since I updated it. I haven't even put my new songs in there or anything like that. This story is gonna be one that happened almost a year ago. This is the like most spiritual mushroom trip I've ever fucking had. And basically this like made me rethink like a lot, and I'll get into the story because like you'll understand why it made me think a lot. Me and my girlfriend had these albino penis envy mushrooms, and at the time we had gotten like 7 grams, but the thing is I don't know who our plug gets our shit from, because it is actually ridiculous, bro. I've never had shrooms this fucking strong. We're like not gonna take the full like eighth, because normally we do like the same amount when we do it, but we're not gonna fucking do the whole eighth. So we decide we're doing like a gram or so. And I thought, you know, a gram, you know, that's not a lot on paper. You know what I'm saying? But I think this grower or something knows something we don't or some shit. Because I had a gram of these albino penis envies, and bro, okay, so it started off like one of those trips that you kind of just yawn into and you don't even feel like you're tripping yet until it's like actually slapping you across the face. We were just walking around. It started to hit me like as we were walking around, and I remember I was looking at these like fixtures on my like tennis court. Because we have these, like, little, like, it's, like, suns with faces in them. Like, sun, like, actual, like, Aztec-looking suns with faces in them. Really fucking trippy on its own. But especially when you're on, like, especially when you're on mushrooms, it's just out there. So I was just staring at this, and I was seeing all the, like, shit moving it. And I was like, no way it's already this fucking strong. And I was thinking, like, I'm outside. I think we need to go back inside. As I'm walking up the stairs, the second wave is hitting me, and all of my vision starts going into like a gold hue. And I only ever had this one time before, and it was also on albino penis envy, but I took like, actually that time I took more. I took like 2 grams, and I had like a spiritual awakening, which like I could also do a video on that one. That was my 21st birthday. But I get into my apartment, and she's tripping balls too. And we're just trying to figure out what the fuck is going on. And we're like, okay, we just need to go to the fucking balcony, sit down for a second, breathe, probably take a bong rip, and then just like fucking exist in this. And so that's kind of, we just like went outside and we smoked and like looked over the balcony for a second, trying to like take in all of like reality, which like all of reality when you look outside my balcony is literally just like another building type shit. But like it's when you're tripping shit like that, everything is just so mesmerizing that like I don't even know. But as we're sitting there, like the weed makes it hit way fucking stronger, not in like a scary way. It's just like it was like we were teeter-tottering at this point between like really tripping and then like not really tripping. So we were like, I don't know how to explain this. We go inside after like another wave starts to hit us, and we start getting the giggles like a motherfucker, and we start going to the bathroom, and we start having all these like me and her both have these like same trips. I don't know how this fucking happens, but we're like sitting there and my fucking brain is just going haywire with all these spiritual thoughts about all of humanity and like why we're here and like as a consequence why we do what we do type shit. And it was literally like my brain, I don't know if this was a bad trip because I was like laughing through all of this and like, you know, but I was just feeling like all of humanity, everyone was feeling all the consequences for everything that humanity's ever done wrong. I don't know why I got that feel. I'm like sitting there laughing shit, like thinking about, dude, all these people work jobs that like use sweatshops or use people to work, and like even when they work properly, what they're selling to people is actually fucking the customers over every single time just because of like the society that we live in. And it wasn't even necessarily capitalism, because it was just like, even when this was like barter and trading, all of this was the same, you know? It's still like the concept was still there. I felt like I was living in an actual meme compilation, but like a real life meme compilation. Does that make any sense? I don't know if anyone else has been through this. I've talked with a couple people who've done shrooms quite a bit, and I've never heard this before, of like feeling like, not necessarily Truman Showy or anything like that, not even necessarily like there's cameras on you. It's literally just like, as a fucking species and as an existence, we live a meme compilation of like all the consequences that like, it's like a trolling compilation from like 2012 COD YouTube. That's like the best way I can explain it, is we're living through that in like first person. We're just laughing a fuck ton at this like concept, just because like at the time we're in the bathroom just, you know, laughing at ourselves laughing. You know what I'm saying? Because like everything is just like so absurd and so like out there, to the point where it's just like hilarious, the fact that like we're at the butt end of this. You know what I'm saying? Because like, and not even in a negative way, it's like at that point I was just genuinely like crying laughing, probably like 5 or 10 minutes into us, or probably more than that. It was probably like 30 minutes of us just genuinely crying laughing in the fucking bathroom. We kind of like not really sober up, but I think like the wave of that come up kind of just like stopped. And we had like a moment of stableness, and we went out to the fucking living room, and we were just trying to like recollect on what the fuck just fucking happened. We were so gone to the point where we were like full ego deathing, like laughing like fucking hyenas in the fucking bathroom. And then we just had like a full on like moment of clarity, like literally second to second. Like it was 1 second we were laughing, another second we came to. And so like we go out to the living room, and we're just like sitting down by the wall, and we're kind of just like trying to collect on what the fuck we just went through, because we're like, the memory is still there, you know what I'm saying? We're not like forgetting what we just went through. We like it fucking like, and we're not sobering up. This is literally just like another like non-come up wave part. You feel me? So we're like sitting there trying to collect what the fuck just happened. And we're like honestly kind of crying. Like we started crying at one point, because like we were like, wait, we don't want bad for the universe. We don't want bad for people. Why are we at the butt end of all this, no matter like what we're born into? You know what I'm saying? Does that not feel like we're like puppets or like slaves of some kind? And that thought kind of just like made us sink into ourselves of like, who are we? Why are we fucking like actually here? Like, what do we want out of life, bro? Because like, real shit, I don't know what the fuck I want. We just started strumming the guitar, no chords, no nothing, just straight strumming it. But the thing is, we were so fucking tripping that it like, we just felt it in our souls, like the no, just the raw strum of a guitar, we felt like it was soul music. Like, I don't even know how to describe it, bro. We're like, fuck it, dude, I need to go smoke. And we decided to go back outside, and we're chilling outside smoking. And we take these couple bong rips, and all of a sudden, I'm astral projecting. We're both astral projecting, but she's having her own experience astral projecting. She said that she experienced a couple past lives. My experience on astral projecting right then and there, because I've astral projected a couple times, but like right then and there, I literally went up out of myself and I was like having a conversation with something that was telling me, like, I was in sophomore year of high school 8 years ago, right? Or like freshman year 8 years ago, somewhere around there. And in another 8 years, I'm going to be the age that my dad and my mom had me. And I only get like 10 or 12 of those 8 year increments, and then most like people die. So like, you know, and that, like, while I was tripping shit, like, I remember I was looking at my like bong and I was looking at all the shit around me, and I like thought about what I was trying to do job wise. And I was like, bro, I need to lock the fuck in. What the fuck? Like, what the fuck am I? What, like, I, like, and not saying that, like, smoking weed is, like, wrong or anything. I just smoked too much. Like, I didn't even want to have a job. I didn't want to do fucking anything, bro. I was, like, straight, like, okay, so I had, like, been out of homelessness, like, probably 7 months. And for those, like, 5 months, I had just been living with my mom trying to collect money for my fucking down payment on this apartment. And we had been in this apartment, like, 2 months. So I was just going fucking buck wild. You feel me? First place I'd ever had. I'm, like, sitting there trying to, like, think of, like, what the fuck am I doing, bro? Because, like, on some real shit, I only, like, Fulcrum says it, but he says it super cheesy. We have access to the present moment, and that's the only way that we can change how we feel about the past, and also what we do in the future, because the future is just made up of a bunch of the present moment. You know what I'm saying? So while I was thinking of all this, I kind of just, like, wanted to get my shit together. That's kind of the, like, vibe I got from it. I kept smoking, obviously. I don't smoke as much as, maybe I do. I don't know. I don't feel like I smoke as much as I used to, but I definitely feel like I get a lot more done. And I especially feel like after that trip, and then, like, a lot of microdosing since then, I feel like I've been more able to deal with cortisol during times of, like, I gotta get shit done, I gotta go to work, I gotta fucking do chores, I gotta do whatever. Because, like, before, I would be so, like, in my head about, like, my own traumatic events, like, literally reliving them, that, like, my dishes would pile up, my laundry would pile up, I wouldn't be able to work, you feel me? So, like, I feel like I'm able to get more done now. I'm still not perfect. Like, for surely I'm still not perfect, but, like, I'm getting a lot better, and I feel like I'm stronger than I used to be. And I feel like I've also got some more connections than I used to, like, real connections, at least, you know? After that point, though, we kind of came, like, we came inside and we were just, like, watching YouTube, and I swear to God, that was only at, like, the 5 hour mark. I was tripping shit for, like, 8.5, 9 hours on this fucking gram dose of albino penis envy. Let that shit sink in, bro. That is ridiculous. I've never heard of no shit like that, especially lemon teching. That shit should be done in, like, 4 hours. I was cooking for 8, 9. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, subscribe if you're new, hit the notification bell. I'll see y'all later. Peace out. Hey, yeah. Wake up in the morning, gotta get it just like